Hi students, let us start the revision of the low limb. First, the commonly asked question is, it's for theory. Femoral triangle. Femoral triangle, you keep this picture in the mind. And this is a real cadaveric picture. Here, this is the triangle. The base is formed by the inguinal ligament. And here, the lateral boundary. And here, the medial boundary. And the lateral boundary is your sartorius. This is the medial border of the sartorius. At least the student should write which border. Okay, this is the medial boundary, this is the medial border of the adductor longus. Can you see this muscle, slanting muscle? And then base, apex is the meeting point of these two. And you have the roof. Roof, at least a student should write skin, superficial fascia and the fascia lata. And on the fascia lata, you have the very important vein going through that. That is your great saphenous vein, which is entering here. And then this is the femoral triangle. So femoral branch of genitofemoral nerve is another one important content. And the next one is the floor. Floor is formed by, first is the muscle called iliacus, psoas major, pectineus and adductor longus. So these are the four muscles you have to mention. At least these are the minimum points we expect in your paper. And the next is your contents. Femoral artery, look at this. This is the femoral artery. And the next is the femoral vein. And next, lateral most is the femoral nerve, femoral artery and femoral vein. So V, A, N, B for vein, A for artery and N for nerve. Nerve is laterally placed. So this is about the femoral triangle. Next, this is a basic information. Next information, what you are supposed to write is femoral nerve root value and what are the anterior and posterior branches. And femoral artery, what is the main branch of the femoral artery? Is the profunda femoris artery. Profunda femoris artery divides the femoral nerve into anterior and posterior division. And then next is the femoral vein. The most important one is the great saphenous vein drains into the femoral vein. And profunda femoris artery, you can write in some extra point as profunda femoris artery gives four perforator branches. And among the four perforators, second perforator is the nutrient artery to the femur, and the fourth perforator is a continuation of profunda femoris. And the next one is femoral artery continues down as the inside, it enters into the subsarterial canal, and then it enters into the next point is it enters into the popliteal fossa as popliteal artery. And then femoral artery is a continuation of external iliac. These are the basic points at least the student should know. I'm just giving the information, only the key points. Okay, for the full theory purpose you need to go for the main video. Subsarterial canal is the second important question, and here is the anterolateral boundary is formed by vastus medialis. Don't write vastus lateralis, because this is the area where you have the subsarterial canal, because the here up to the apex the femoral triangle stops. From here is a subsarterial canal. So this is your canal area, and here is the anterolateral boundary. It is formed by the vastus medialis. Can you see this? Here only you have the vastus lateralis. So anterolateralis, vastus medialis, and posteriorly you have the upper part of adductor longus, lower part you have the adductor magnus, and on the roof you have the sartorius and subsarterial plexus of nerves. So these are the points you are supposed to write. And then the contents, femoral artery. The femoral artery, look at this, femoral artery is laterally placed. It has to cross the vein and it has to come medially. That is the most important relation you have to write. Femoral artery and femoral vein, and saphenous nerve and descending genicular branch, the branch from the femoral. And this is about the hamstring muscle. Hamstring muscle was asked as an essay question for me in the university exam way back 1997. Hamstring muscle, right? So here is the ischial tuberosity. All of you keep this picture in mind and write the MCQs also. So the ischial tuberosity will be divided into upper half and the lower half. Upper half also you have to divide it by your oblique line into, and medial, inframedial and the supralateral part. Supralateral you have the semimembranosus, inframedial you have the semitendinosus and long enough biceps origin, and the lower part medially you have the hamstring part of adductor magnus. So the most importantly, all the hamstring muscles are supplied by the tibial component of sciatic nerve. Except the shorted off biceps, it is supplied by the common peroneal nerve, right? So, and this shorted off biceps femoris also arises from the linea aspera. This is a very important point. You have to keep it in mind. This alone will be asked in the MCQ. And then next is, at least the student should know, hamstring muscles means it originates from the ischial tuberosity. Next is the femoral nerve. Femoral nerve, the salient key points are, this is the arises from the dorsal division of L2, L3, L4. Because ventral division of L2, L3, L4 is obturator nerve. And the lateral border of psoas major, it comes through the lateral border of psoas major. Then it enters into the femoral triangle. In the femoral triangle, it occupies the lateral most part and divides into two divisions by the lateral circumflex femoral artery. And anteriorly, you have the anterior intermediate cutaneous branches. And posteriorly, the most important branch you have to keep it in mind is saphenous nerve. And anterior branches supply the hip joint and posterior division supplies the knee joint. And muscular branches, all the muscles of the anterior compartment are supplied by the femoral nerve. Next is the femoral artery. It is a continuation of external iliac. We have already seen that. And superficial branches, superficial circumflex iliac. Superficial circumflex iliac and superficial external pudendal, superficial epigastric. Open. Okay. So while drawing femoral artery, you keep it in mind, this is your umbilical area, right? So here is the artery, this is the inguinal canal. So one goes to the pudendal, another goes to the iliac circumflex iliac, another goes to the epigastric. So these three are called the superficial branches. And then the deep branches are, already I told you, profunda femoris artery. Profunda femoris also, I said, this is the main femoral artery. And here is the profunda femoris. Profunda femoris has four perforator branches. The fourth perforator is the continuation of profunda femoris. Second is the very important uterine artery to femur. And the first perforator will be forming in the anastomosis, the trochanteric anastomosis. Okay, right. So that's about the femoral artery main points. And the next is here gluteus maximus. Gluteus maximus origin is from the posterior gluteal line, sacrum, what are all the nearby bones you are supposed to write. At least this point should be there in your paper. So for origin, we will be giving you marks, 2 marks. Posterior gluteal line, sacrum, coccyx, and the very important sacrotuberous ligament. Insertion is MCQ because 3/4 is inserted into the tensor fasciae latae and 1/4 is inserted into the gluteal tuberosity. And the nerve supply is, though it is maximus, it is supplied by inferior gluteal nerve. And the action is extension of the hip joint. And the structures under cover of the gluteus maximus is, one is medius, another is minimus, beneath that, another one is piriformis, superior inferior gamelle and tendon of obturator internus and quadratus femoris. All these are called short muscles of the pelvis. So how to remember the short muscles? So first is gluteus maximus. If you reflect the gluteus maximus, you will be having the medius, beneath that you have the minimus, and this is the key muscle called the piriformis. Above the piriformis you have the superior gluteal vessels and nerves, inferior to the piriformis inferior gluteal vessels and nerves. And the most important sciatic nerve is coming. And the next muscles are, keep it in mind, first is one tendon is coming, that is tendon of obturator internus. Above that you have the superior gamellus, below that you have the inferior gamellus. Next is quadratus femoris. So these are the muscles you are supposed to write. These are all called short muscles of the pelvis posterior compartment. They are all called as lateral rotators of the hip joint. Very important MCQ. Okay, this is about the gluteus maximus. And the next one is medius. This clinical question will be asked, what is called Trendelenburg sign? Trendelenburg sign is nothing but when you stand on one leg, the opposite side pelvis will be going up because of the contraction of the gluteus medius on the same side. Can you understand? When you stand on one leg, if for example, this is the pelvis, okay, right? When you stand on one leg, what will happen? This side, opposite side pelvis will go up because of the contraction of this side gluteus medius. But this gluteus medius is supplied by the superior gluteal nerve. If this nerve is injured, what will happen? This side pelvis cannot contract. If it is not able to contract, what will happen to the opposite side? Will it go? No. So what happened? The pelvis sinks down. So the pelvis sinks down. It comes down. That is called as Trendelenburg test. Actually, this is called positive Trendelenburg test. Another one, Trendelenburg sign, is your varicose veins. That will be coming later. Okay. So this point should be there in your paper. We'll see the next video, part 2 video, in the next. Thank you.